been arguing that the priorities we've got, a long priority list, is a lot of buildings to deal with, and the priorities only touch the surface of the buildings that we have to deal with. And we think, and this is the main point of this motion, that Liverpool is in a particular situation, a particular financial situation, and a particular challenge that we face, that the government should recognise that and should back success, help Liverpool to do even more in the years that are coming. The mayor constantly says Liverpool's best days are ahead. I think that's absolutely true. I think in terms of heritage, that is particularly true. And this motion's main point is the government needs to back us even more in achieving what we need to achieve.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. I urge Council to oppose Councillor Kemp's amendment. As Councillor Kennedy said, it comes in the complete opposite spirit of the rest of the motion. It undermines the main principle of the motion, the main message of the motion, which is when it comes to heritage, this Labour Council knows what it's doing. This Labour administration is handling the city's heritage assets in a responsible and positive way. And our own ward of Picton, I'm delighted to see action to bring the Liverpool building back into use. Even though, strictly speaking, it's not a heritage building at all, it's not even listed, but we're bringing it back into use. And working with partners of Riverside Housing to bring back into use the listed fire station and Chipperies pubs on Durney Road. I'm also pleased that the Council's Heritage Champion will be meeting with us to look at how we can save Toxteth Park Cemetery, another Grade 2 listed building at risk. This amendment ignores all the good work on big high profile projects and small local schemes being carried on by this administration. The work we do shows how desperate we are to maintain and find purpose for the buildings of all designs and all ages. The amendment almost seeks to deny that, but by applying that, in his opinion, we should be doing something different. In his opinion. You see, when it comes to architecture and heritage, we are not short of opinions, and opinions can be wrong. For example, when the Eiffel Tower was built, Guy de Maupassant and Alexandre Dumas wrote a letter saying, "We protest with all our strength the useless and monstrous Eiffel Tower. The Eiffel Tower is without dust, it is under a penny."
I thought that was an absolutely fantastic contribution to
tackled this city
at every opportunity he gets for his own leaflets. Leaflets are now going across his ward, lying about this council selling 18 acres of land with cold stones. That's what he's about. Just attacking and damaging this city and its reputation. And then, you know, when he talks about the buildings and the quality of buildings, and he wants us to engage Jonathan Brown from the Civic Society, get him onto a panel, who's worked with him as a Crowley, helping attack the city. The reality is, you've only got to look on the docks anyway. You see the car park, the car bunkle, right next to the Liver building, which they gave permission for. And then that white monstrosity on the Albert dock that they gave permission for. And he wants to tell us what to do. You keep your advice and put it where I believe the sun shouldn't ever shine. You keep your advice and let us get on with managing this building in the best way that we can against the amendment.
Councillor Norris, right to the advice of the amendment. Voting for the amendment, 4-3, against 73, 4 abstentions, the amendment is lost. So we move now to the main motion. Councillor Norris, would you like to write a few points?
What we're saying, Lord Mayor, is I'm going to accept the comments that Councillor Norris has made. Okay.
Is that agreed? Agreed. We go to the vote. Do we need any ideas? Unanimous? Thank you. Motion 16, scrutiny arrangements, and I invite Councillor Richard Kemp to move the motion standing in his name.
Thank you very much. I want to look in our discussion here tonight at the future, not the past. It is no secret that I do not believe in the mayoral model. I opposed it from day one. And the fact is that I can't prove whether the mayoral model was better or worse for Liverpool than the leader of the council model, and neither can anyone else, because we've done no evaluation. think has been passed today, and it's certainly about to be passed, which is the devolution bill, which, whether we like it or not, and I've made clear we're prepared to accept it for the good of the devolution that will come down to the city region, will include an elected Liverpool City Region there. So there are two questions. Do we really want to have an elected city region mayor, an elected city mayor, and an elected in a different way, Lord Mayor, all of course the title of Liverpool? I believe that's confusing, I believe it's unnecessary, and that's legally, if the bill has become an act, we have no alternative than having the elected Liverpool City Region there. And I would never vote to abolish the position of the law there at Liverpool. That only leaves one that can be taken out. And I'm quite clear that we need to return to the lead of the council model. But if we do that, in the 2011 Local Government Act, we can go further. Because I believe that we need to return to a committee system. Not the committee system that went on for decades and decades in this city. I used to chair a committee of 27 people. We had 11 of them. They had subcommittees, working groups, task groups. Sometimes you had joint committees, sometimes you had joint task groups. No, we don't want that. But the fact is that in some ways, under the leadership of this mayor, we've already begun to return to a committee system. At the last meeting of the Regeneration Committee, there were two items put forward for pre-decision scrutiny. And that's what I believe every matter should be coming forward as. Coming together, not as a recommendation from on high from the Cabinet, but coming through the committee system in a rapid and effective system in which every single councillor can have a say into policy before it is effectively decided. And that's what I believe we would return to. I believe that would reinvigorate democracy. I believe that that would give every council a much greater sense of purpose for what we do in council buildings. And this has nothing to do with our role as ward councillors. There's so much that every member of the council does in that role. So much of what goes on in our buildings, largely in this town hall now, as we have no real committee rooms, is actually rather negative and rather pointless, and I've said repeatedly, is involving the mass consumption of PowerPoint presentations. So, just as a simple thing, we can't have three Liverpool mayors, and if we're going to abolish the one in Liverpool, which is the only one that I can see change, then let's take the opportunity to look at our system of governance as a whole, and in doing so, I put down on record that I believe a move to a simplified and effective committee system would be the favour that I would like to see considered at that time.
Are there any other speakers? Mayor Allen's.
This is again another attempt for Councillor Kemp for his leaflet. It's been made absolutely clear by me, I mean at this council meeting, what I said is that if there is a male city region model adopted, then this council, whenever it decides to make a decision on what it does, the law as it currently stands is that after 5 years, when a male model is adopted, that after that, you have to wait 5 years, that takes us to May 2017. I'm really disappointed that we're actually debating and discussing this, because it is, as I said, just an attempt by Councillor Kemp to get something in the leaflet or to try and get something in the press around scrutiny. The reality is, absolutely, no doubt, 17 select committees, we had male select committees, he turned up to five. We've probably had, in my tenure as leader and then mayor, cabinet meetings, probably somewhere around around 280 over the period that I've been in that position. I think Councillor Radford's turned up to the most, followed by the Greens. Has he turned up to any? No. Number of select committees that we've got, literally hundreds of select committees. Has he turned up to any? Only the one he's on. Has he turned up to
three?
No, there are three that he's on. And that's only a few, usually in Russia or America or Barbados or Vietnam or somewhere else. The reality is that this council has not changed its scrutiny. There is no decision, not one decision, that I have made as mayor of this city that wasn't open for scrutiny. Not one decision. All of them open to calling, open to debate at cabinet, open to cabinet in terms of the select committees that the papers would want. And you're absolutely right that we referred things to select committees for pre-discussion beforehand. So to sit there or to stand up and claim that this is about scrutiny and bring them back scrutiny. There was no worse administration ever in the history of this city that denied scrutiny. You alone denied scrutiny of your role and this council's role in the Booster State. We witnessed that. You swept the audacity of the chief to lecture me about scrutiny. To lecture me. Not one decision. Not one. It's actually been unscrutinised. Every decision that we've taken has been available to scrutiny. And when we make a decision to respond to the mayoral regional elections, it will be done by this administration, and it will be done when we're ready to do that, not when you think it's good for you to put something in the echo or in your leaflet.
made by this administration or indeed this council. I argue that there should have been, before we move to a mayoral system, a referendum, which happened in the vast majority of cities where the mayoral model was rejected. And I'm calling for the review to start now, because I believe it's the people of this city who should control this city. It's the people of this city who should decide what constitutional model we should have. We can't have a referendum on it for a variety of reasons, but I think a proper review, a proper discussion with the people of the city is far more appropriate than just to let the politicians, with their own interests at stake, make the decisions about the future governance of this body. That's why I don't believe we should wait for the largesse of the Labour Party. I think we should involve the people of the city today.
All those for the motion. All those in favour? Voting for the motion, 8-4, against 78, no abstentions, the motion is lost. Can I advise that in accordance with Standing Order 7.2, agenda items 17 and 18 have been recommended by the whips, indicating that they have cross-party support. Are these motions now agreed? Can I now say that in relation to agenda items 19, 20 and 21 have been referred directly to the appropriate select committees? Well, that would mean that's the end of the business for tonight. So can I thank you all for your fellow members who've spoken and for your behaviour.